we always want to make sure that the wire or cord is against the glass when making our cuts. As you can see, I'm making my cut, and I want to make sure that the angle of the opening of the Cobra is facing my cord or wire. My dash protector, move it over, and continue my cut. If I start to feel that maybe I'm getting a little tension on the cord, maybe there's a heavy puck usually in the center, I want to maybe increase pressure as I go around that area or cut through that area. Again, I want to move my dash protector over. Get my wire between the dash protector or the glass and the glass on my cord. That's where we're using the rip cord. If there's any stops, I want to make sure that I bypass the stops. In this case, I did not have any stops, so I didn't have to worry on this vehicle that I'm working on. I'm going to go to the opposite side of the vehicle. And you can see how I'm working my way across the bottom. Again, I want to make sure that the window, the opening of the Cobra, is facing my wire or my cord. I'm going to now move the Cobra. I'm going to remove the ratcheting device, the ratchet, disconnect the cup. I'm going to release the tab here, pull it outward, and it's going to release the wire or the cord. Now, this opening here that you see here, I want to make sure that I face it on the corner, so this way as I'm making my cut, it doesn't go against the edge of the Cobra and creating resistance. I want to have less resistance, so I want to have open space, the window. So I'm going to turn it here facing the corner, and as I can see that the cord is okay, I'm not going to be putting it under a bind on the tool on itself. Again, I'm going to pump it up until the red line disappears on the plunger itself here. Get my ratchet, there's a push button on the ratchet. I'm gonna push it in, falls in place, and I start to cut again. Before I do that, I wanna make sure that the edge is okay and it's all right. I'm gonna move over, make sure that I go between the glass and the dash and that the wire of the cord stays against it. I've also made sure that I am close to the A-pillar and I've injected the dash protector into the A-pillar. This way I make sure that the cord does not come in contact with my A-pillar. Now, I can see that my cord is starting to move, so I'm going to anchor that on the inside. And I've brought my rip cord, my secondary rip cord, into the vehicle. I'm going to get my anchor and I'm going to run the rip cord through my anchor, lacing it. making a knot on it or two. Pull a little bit of it out. Inserting it and locking it in place, just like I would do wire. Then I'm going to face the pin to where the wire or cord has not cut. So this is the other end. So I'm going to cut from this point. Okay. So I'll go back to the opposite side. I've got my rip cord anchored. I'm going to the opposite side of the vehicle and continue where I left off. Put my gloves back on. And continue. You're gonna start to see the wire on the other side start to tighten up a little bit, or not, depending. Keeping the cord against the glass. And now I'm going to release the ratchet. Release the cup. I'm going to pull the tab out, expose more wire, turn the window, the opening of the Cobra, pump it up, tighten it up. Take this off, and then I'm going to use my installation stick, keeping the wire or the cord against the glass, putting my ratchet back in. And working my way up. I could also use my finger to guide it. And just work it little at a time. I'm following my wire or cord with my finger on the wire or cord. I'm going to release the ratchet button, release the Cobra, release the tab, expose some more. Now, if I have a frit on the windshield for the shade or the visor, I want to make sure that if it's in the glass, I can go ahead and mount the Cobra onto it. But if not, then I would need to go further out to where the area is clean and I don't have to worry about the cup turning loose. Again, if the frit, the dot matrix, is on the interior of the glass, not in the glass in the lamination, I want to make sure that I keep that away, the cup away from that area. Now, this particular vehicle had stops. Now, what I want to make sure is that I bypass that stop, just like so, and continue on my way, keeping the insulation stick between it. Just rocking and rolling. Now I'm going to go to the opposite side. Again, I want to make sure that I keep the wire or the cord against the glass and away from the interior. I'm going to go ahead and release the ratchet, remove the cup from the glass, release the tab, bring it over to the corner, make sure that the opening, this opening it's almost facing upward. So this way, my cut will not come in contact with the edge of the Cobra. Now in this corner, there is another stop. So when I get closer, I'm going to lower the Cobra so that this way I don't come in contact with that stop or placement pin, should I say. Okay, release the ratchet, release the cup, release the wire tab, and I'm going to put it about midway. Pump it up, fit my ratchet, push the button on the ratchet. Get my installation stick and make sure that I get behind the stop just right there in the corner. And work my way down. Now, I want to make sure that if the cord starts to move at the bottom, I want to make sure that my dash protector is between the trim panel, the A-pillar here, and the dash. So this way, if the secondary wire, the anchor starts to move, it doesn't come in contact with the dashboard or with the A-pillar trim. I'm gonna move my cup slightly. Release the ratchet. Turn the anchor, the angle, so that my opening is now facing closer to my end of my cut. Pump it up. Push the button on the tab of the ratchet. Get my phone. Put between the trim panel. And work my way down. Again, always make sure you keep your wire and your cord against the glass. This is going to keep it from getting hung up on the trim panel and also keeps it from having too much resistance. You want the least resistance as possible. I need to change the angle. My cut, again, slightly. Give myself a cord. Angle it downward. This way the cord is and want to crisscross them. Get that between it. So the last final cut, I'm going to crisscross them here. And there we are.